Is this just another fight to you?
It is. It's another chapter. It's another fight in my career. I'm always going to take the responsibility as always.
Miguel, in the past, you said that you didn't want to fight too much more, only a few more fights. How close are we to that, the end, or have you thought about it?
I said earlier in my career that when I'm 30, I'm going to retire myself. I'm 34 already. I'm still here. I don't know what I can say about it. I'm going to be here until I feel it.
Your biggest purse you've ever made. How happy are you with that?
I'm happy.
You better be.
Miguel, how do you like Rock Nation? Your second fight with them, right?
Rock Nation, they became a couple months ago that the best interest for me, for my family, and now Jormark and all the staff from Rock Nation, they became family to us.
Miguel, you said this is just a regular fight, but this will be your biggest payday and arguably the biggest rivalry in boxing, Puerto Rico versus Mexico. Is this really just a regular fight?
This is really what?
I said arguably this is probably the biggest rivalry in boxing, Puerto Rico versus Mexico, and your biggest payday. Is this really just a regular fight to you?
I don't say regular, I said just another fight.
Just another fight.
It is. It's another fight. It's a new chapter, make a career.
If you win here, if Mayweather rematch, would obviously be front and center. Is that what you're aiming for in your career?
I'm just aiming and just putting my eye on the victory. After that, we'll see what happens.
How bad?
Who do you think wins? Golovkin or Lemieux?
No. He said he's going to retire after this fight. I can look for something or for somebody who is going to be out of boxing.
Yeah, what do you think of the WBC mandating the winner of this fight, fighting the winner of Golovkin and Lemieux? Are you open to that fight? There's always a lot of talk about that.
I'm always open to every fight. The best opponent I have after Canelo, I'm going to go for it. For him.
Are you surprised that he sold 15,000 tickets in Madison Square Garden, Golovkin?
No.
So you said that if you do win and that's the next fight, you will fight him?
If it's the best interest for me, I'm going for that.
Miguel, you mentioned the consecutive losses before Frank. At that point, did you start to think, well, maybe this is it? Maybe it's time?
Like I said, I arrived at the wild card, put nothing in my hands, just to check if still having something happens. You know, first just bring myself back to the rail, bring myself back to the track, and we're here.
So you went there to find out if you had what you had left.
What?
So you went there to find out what you had left.
What you have left, yeah. What I have left.
Hey Miguel, why were you able to do better against Mayweather than Canelo did?
I think he gets frustrated after a couple rounds trying to stop Mayweather, chasing him, and I'm not. I'm just trying to be on top of it.
Miguel, did you take anything from your brother's fight? Like, did you call your brother for advice? Did he give you any...
Every fight different, you know? I didn't talk to my family of boxing, but every fight different, you know? My brother was different. After my brother, Canelo, had so much fights, and our fight on November 21st is going to be another fight.
Miguel.
Canelo, una preguntita. De todas las peleas que han participado entre mexicanos y puertorriqueños, ¿cuál ha sido la mejor para usted?
No he sido un fiel seguidor del boxeo. Como mencioné anteriormente, la más que recuerdo fue la de Salvador Sánchez y Alfredo Gómez.
Miguel, ¿qué cambió en esta ocasión a la anterior vez de que en esta ocasión sí se dio la pelea? Porque ya te lo habían ofrecido antes.
Los intereses, pudimos ponernos de acuerdo en todo y la pelea se dio cuando se tenía que dar, que era en ese momento.
¿Estás contento que esperaste a esta ocasión?
Sí, todo ocurre cuando debe ocurrir, todo tiene un propósito.
Can someone just translate that for us? Help us out. Anybody here?
We ran out of translators.
Miguel, Freddie said you're going to win by knockout. Freddie said you're going to win by knockout in the late rounds. What do you think? Do you agree?
Dave, yes. Can you help translate?
Yeah.
I'm always...
Me and Brian here. Please. Can you help translate?
We want to make sure
the same, you know, on the side of Freddie. You know, if we believe that, if we believe I can do that, I believe.
Miguel, how do you think you're going to be remembered? You're one of the best Puerto Rican fighters right now. When your career is over, how do you want to be remembered?
I don't know. All I care is my family, what they think, what they believe, and what they want from me. The way they think about me, I'm going to be agree with that.
You know, you say this is a regular fight, but do you think it's going to be one of those fights that's going to, I don't want to say define you, but one of the fights that when they talk about Miguel Cotto, they'll talk about this fight. There's certain fights that fighters fight that people talk about. Is this going to be one of them?
My whole career, I put my enthusiasm, I put everything I had in my fights. This fight is going to be the same.
Miguel, Felix Verdejo is picking you to beat Canelo. What's your comment about Verdejo picking you to win?
Felix is our star from Puerto Rico. I respect him a lot. I'm just going to... Like I said, I'm going to do my best every day at the training camp, and I want to thank him for that.
Miguel, who do you think won the Canelo versus Lara fight?
I didn't see the fight.
You never seen it?
No.
Miguel, any advice? Your career has been a roller coaster, from really high to low to high. Any advice for young fighters who are going through what you went through? How do you survive in this business?
Hard work is just the only thing that keep us on the winning road is the hard work.
Miguel, you guys are going to face off right now outside. Is that the first round of the fight? How important is the face off and looking away? You know, we've seen guys stare at each other for like 2 minutes and neither wants to give up. Is that important to you as a fighter?
It's just a rule of boxing. It's just a ceremony of boxing. The only thing we're going to dictate who's going to be the winner is going to be ourselves on our training camps.
Have you and Canelo exchanged words as far as like when you guys see each other?
Yeah, I have nothing against him, you know, it's just my work.
¿Qué dices tú cuando que hablas con tu familia antes de venir a Los Ángeles por 12 semanas para entrenar? ¿Cómo haces como padre para mantener la relación mientras estás aquí?
Mis hijos llevan toda su vida en el boxeo conmigo, saben los sacrificios que yo tengo que hacer y lo que ellos tienen que hacer en mi carrera, y todo está claro entre mi familia, el boxeo y yo.
Miguel, ¿qué tienes más desventaja psicológicamente o el atletismo más que Canelo para esta pelea?
¿Perdón?
¿Piensas que tienes más la ventaja psicológicamente, la preparación mental para esta pelea que Canelo?
La preparación aún no comienza, de mi parte, comenzará el próximo 28 de septiembre, y yo me encargaré de que no haya duda alguna en mi mente de que yo voy a ser bueno.
Miguel, ¿a usted le intimida de alguna manera alguna cosita de ir a México a esta promoción?
Para nada, gracias a Dios el pueblo mexicano siempre me ha tratado muy bien, el pueblo mexicano siempre me ha hecho sentir muy bien cada vez que he tenido la oportunidad de visitar México. Y estoy ansioso por llegar a México.
Miguel, ¿te motiva la posibilidad de vencer a la estrella más grande de México en el boxeo?
Yo trabajaré incansablemente para obtener la victoria, y la motivación no será vencer a la estrella más grande de México en este momento, sino será ir solidificando el futuro de mi familia.
Miguel, do you remember the first day you walked in the gym?
That was some day in the summer of 1992.
Why?
Because I was so heavy, I was a chubby guy trying to lose weight, and that was my main purpose, just to be sitting down.
So you never dreamt of championships, of millions, of anything?
No, I just want to lose weight.
How long did it take you to lose weight
by gym? My brother started boxing first, and I just want to follow them. spend more time with them.
So you saw results from your weight pretty quickly when you got in the gym?
Like 3 months after, I lost like 40 pounds.
40 pounds? Yeah. From what to what? Do you remember?
I was in 160, 65 when I started.
Yeah.
And 3-4 months after that, I was in 115, 120 pounds.
Oh. New clothes, huh?
Yeah.
When did you realize you'll be a Hall of Famer, one of the best to ever do it? At what point?
I'm just a regular boxer. No. I am not a Hall of Famer yet. I'm just trying to do the best I can do in boxing.
Right, but
did you learn anything from Canelo, from the negotiations or anything like that? Anything he wanted that you got to put your foot down about, or any had to go back and forth about, or anything?
That was just a normal negotiation fight.
What do you think about being the A side and you're the underdog?
I am just Miguel Cotto. Nobody brings something to me. Everything I have today is because I earned it. And people going to see what happened. What's going to happen on November 21st.
Why do you think whenever I ask any Puerto Rican fighter, Rosado, Danny Garcia, they all say Miguel Cotto wins no matter who you're fighting?
We're Puerto Ricans.
Stick together.
That's all.
Miguel, you said you're making the most money for this fight. Floyd just made $275 million. Can you wrap your head around that? I mean, did that even shock you, how much money was generated in that fight with Pacquiao?
The only pocket I can put my hand on is mine.
Miguel, you're not just an ordinary fighter. You're absolutely a Hall of Famer. And how close were you the fight being in New York versus Vegas versus Texas?
Texas never was an option. They didn't present an offer for us. New York was solid at the beginning, but then Vegas appears with the best benefit for us.
Miguel, Freddy mencionó que en esta pelea espera que tú no quedes a Canelo los últimos asaltos. ¿Qué tiene que decir sobre eso?
Freddy sabe que lo que tiene que hacer, Freddy sabe lo que tiene que decir en cada sesión de entrenamiento para poner a Miguel Cotto donde él quiere que Miguel Cotto esté. Y si Freddy, cualquier cosa que Freddy diga, yo estoy con él.
Gracias.
Question was, Freddy said that the fight was going to go to the distance, and they'll say whatever Freddy said, I'm behind it, I'll work hard for it. So we're together in this one.
Any message to your fans who are going to tune in pay-per-view November 21st?
Yes. There's going to be a great fight November 21st. When you put Canelo in one corner and Miguel Cotto in the other one, all you can expect from that is a real fight.
What's your favorite Mexican food?
Hey, Tinda. Tacos al pastor is one of them.
But how are they received here in LA, like Mexican fans? I mean, you've been training out here. How have they received? What's the interaction been with Mexican fans?
Mexican people always treat me really good, with a lot of respect. All I have for them is respect and love.
You like it out here in LA better than the other training camps you had in Miami and Florida?
I have a better mind, a better kind of mind here in LA. Zero distractions for me. And I prefer Vegas. I prefer LA. Okay.
Two or three more questions.
Miguel, Danny Garcia, Manny Pacquiao. Freddy said he likes that fight. What do you think? Puerto Rico, Philippines?
Freddy is a great trainer. I know he's going to do his best with Manny. And it's going to be a great fight.
Miguel, do you know you're sparring it for this fight? Are you going to use bigger guys for this fight? Or?
You can ask Freddy about it.
Any Cotto promoted fighters on the undercard?
I think so.
Definitely.
Yes.
Any in mind? Or?
All right, go ahead.
We'll discuss in there.
Okay. Thank you guys very much.
Nice to be here.
Thank you, Miguel. Good luck. Gracias. Thank you.